In this session, we are going to see the topic Theoretical Relational Languages comes under the Unit 1. In the previous class, we have learned about database concepts and introduction and the integrity rules. Now we are going to see about Theoretical Relational Languages. The contents are, first is theoretical languages, relational algebra, relational algebra operations, applications of relational algebra, relational calculus, and applications of relational calculus. These are the contents that we are going to see now. So, first, theoretical languages. So, hope you remember the researcher name E.F. Code, what I have said you about in the suggestion he gave related to relational concepts in the previous class. So, that relational concept is being extended here as a relational language to use with the relational model. So, E.F. Code is a researcher whose research is based only on the relational database management system of the type of model called as relational model. So what is it he do means he suggested two languages. The first language is relational algebra. It is a procedural language, and second language is relational calculus. It is a non-procedural language. Hope you remember about the language in computer science where it is used to communicate with a machine. So, for dealing with relational model database systems, he suggested to use these two languages. One is algebra and one is calculus. Both depends upon relational. That is relational in the sense, it depends upon the tables. Hope you remember, relation means it is table, what we learned in the previous class. So, procedural language and non-procedural language is the outcome difference between these two. So, relational languages can work on the entire group or on a group of rows. So, it is going to only deal with the relational tables that is in the form of rows and columns. So, here in the theoretical languages, there is a concept of no looping. You are not going to apply any looping structure like you hope you remember that what you learnt in other languages like for, do, while and all. These type of loopings is not supported in this theoretical language, and you are going to apply only very little coding. Coding has been minimized a lot, and you can embed in this particular theoretical language in other host languages. That is, you can embed it in other high level languages. So these are some of the advantages in the theoretical language. So first language is relational algebra. So what it is, already we have shown on the first slide, it is a procedural language. So procedure in the sense, it is a name step by step. So user will get the result by applying set of operations in a sequence. Set of operations in step by step, they will apply and they will retrieve the result. So here, this procedural language, it uses set operations on the tables. It is going to apply the set operations on the tables to produce new resulting table. So resulting tables are then used for subsequent sequential operation. You can also apply those intermediate table for further processing. And totally there are 9 operations that can be achieved with this help of relational algebra. 9 operations are there. So what are those 9 operations? The first one is union. Union is your first operator. And second one is intersection. Third one operator is difference. Fourth one is projection. Fifth one is selection. Sixth one is product. Seventh one is assignment. Eighth one is join. And ninth one is division. So these are the nine operations that is applied in relational algebra. It is a procedural language. So now we will see what are those nine operations, how it performs in this relational database. So there is a relational algebra operation. As I said, it can be compatible or it can be compared with your set theory. So what is in set theory? You have learnt about union, intersection, difference and cross product. These have the same meaning here. And in relational database, the new type of operation that you are going to see is select, project and join. So what is meant by select and project is, it is going to deal with your retrieving data from the table. The retrieving is called as extracting from a single relation. Hope you remember, relation is nothing but it is a table. And join, you're going to combine the two relations. That is called as join. So set operations, you have learned here, what you have learned is union, intersection, difference and cross product. That also we can be learned or compared with the normal set theory that you have studied in mathematics. So the first operation, set operation, is union. It is denoted by R union S. This is a symbol for union operation. And union means all tuples in either R or S. Now I think you will remember tuple means it is denoting row in a table. R is a table and S is a table. So this union operation is applied on the table. R is on table and S is another table. You are going to apply this union operation in this particular both the tables, means you will retrieve all the rows from the table. This is the first operation. And the second operation is intersection. Intersection is the second operation. This is the symbol that has been denoted for intersection. It means all the tuples in both R and S, it should be in common. Here it is either or S, here both. So intersection means which is common value only you will take in the normal mathematical set theory. The same concept and the same meaning is applied over here in the form of tables. And the third operation is difference. Difference means R minus S. So what it is? All tuples in R but not in S. You're going to retrieve only the tuples, that is only the rows in the table R, not in the table S. And the fourth operation is Cartesian product. You're going to multiply, product in the sense multiplication. This product you're going to apply with the symbol into symbol. You're going to pair all the tuples in R with all the tuples in S. So these are the four types of set operations that is normally what you learned on your set theory that is being carried over here on this relational algebra. Relation on the algebra in the sense in the form of tables. So these operations is going to apply on the tables. One of the most important point is when you're dealing with this set operation, it must be in the form of union compatible. Union compatible, if you apply for union or intersection or difference, what operation it may be, the one and only rule is union compatible, meaning that you should have the same attribute types. That is, your columns should be of the same nature. Hope you remember, attribute means it is a column and tuple or entity means it is a row. What I have said in the previous class. So first operation of the relational algebra is union. So union of the two tables. So here you are going to apply for tables. So the union of two tables results in the retrieval of all rows that are in one or both tables. So it will retrieve all the rows either in first table or in second table or else, or it will combine all the rows, and duplicate rows will be eliminated from the resulting table. So after the union operation, duplicate rows will be eliminated. And the resulting table does not contain two rows with identical data values. That is, the duplicate will be eliminated, only identical rows will be inserted in the resulting table. So what are the basic requirement to perform this union operation on the relational table is, The first one is both tables must have the same degree. Same degree it should be applied. And the second rule is the domains of the corresponding columns in two tables must be same. Degree should also be same and the domain also should be same. So these two rules are called as union compatible. Meaning that in relational algebra, a union can be performed only on the union compatible tables. Union compatible same tables means your tables must have the same degree and the particular columns should be of in the same domain. So these are the two rules. Degree in the sense, it also dealing with columns. So now we will see the example that has been given in your prescribed textbook. And hope you remember in the previous class, I have shown the screenshot of all the existing tables in the followed for the examples in the prescribed book. So from that, I'm going to take two tables. That is to all example given is supposed to see all the projects from years 2002 and 2003 by performing a union on project 2002 and project 2003. That is, there are tables called 2002 and 2003 project. This is a table name and you're going to apply a union operation to see all the projects. This is a question given. So this is a project 2002 table. It has three columns and five rows. It has five rows and three columns. And project 2003 is here. It is also has three rows and five columns. So the basic requirement, same degree and column must be same. It has been satisfied. So this union compatible is satisfied in this table. So now we can able to get the resulting table in the form of A. That is, it is going to combine all the rows into the resulting table. And if any repeated row, it will be deleted. For example, you can see this row 1, location Miami and stocks. Customer stocks is being repeated over here. And the same way, project number 3, Trenton and Smith is being repeated over here. So, this repeated values will be eliminated in the resulting table. That is, duplicates will be avoided. This entry will come only once. Now, we will check the result. See, 3, 4, 5 and here 9. 9 rows are there. Totally 9 rows are there and from that 2 rows are repeated. So eliminating those 2, you will get the 7 rows in the resulting table. So only this 1 and 3 is resulted only once, one time, not for twice. So hope you understand, this is the union operation that is performed on the table. So union set theory operation has been applied in this relational algebra in the form of tables. So tables is nothing but this is a relation is called as a table. Now we will move on to the second relational algebra operation called as intersection. As the name indicates, it will produce a table with rows that are in both tables. Both table, here also you have to follow the concept of union compatible to perform an intersection on them. Union compatible in the sense, as I told now, you should have the same number of columns on same number of domains in the both the tables. So this is an example. The same table is used in what you have applied in the union. There is project 2002 and project 2003. What you have applied is the same table we are taking for the intersection operation also. So resulting table, what you will get? Can you guess any idea here? Intersection, there is common what exists in the both table will be the result. So common is 1 and 3, that you will get in the resulting table. See here, 1 and 3. Only these two tables will be in the result, not all the rows. Only these two rows will be in the resulting table. So this is what called as intersection. Only it will retrieve the common values. And the third operation is difference. So what is meant by difference? The difference of two tables produce a table with rows that are present in the first table but not in the second table. So only what the rows that will be present in the first table will be in the resulted table. The second table will not be considered. So here also you have to perform on the union compatible tables only. Same tables what you have applied for union, you are taking. There is project 2002 and project 2003. The operation you applied is table C. That is what you are going to do is you are minusing project 2002 and 2003. So the resulting table will be only this 5, 6, 7. Since 1 and 3, well, here these two exist in this project 2003. 5, 6, 7 is the difference of a row. So that came in the resulting table. Project 2002 minus 2003. Similarly, if you apply this project 2003 minus 2002, you will get the different result like this. 2 and 4. Since this 2 and 4 is a different element that compare with this first table. Here already 1 and 3 exist in the project 2002 also. The does not exist element is rows 2 and 4. That will be resulted here because A minus B is not equal to B minus A. This is the concept in difference operation. Now we will move to the next operation called projection. What is meant by projection? You are going to create a table based on desirable columns from all existing columns in a table. That is, you are going to select only particular columns that you need from a table. A table may contain more than 10 columns or 15 columns, but you need only for 4 columns. You can easily retrieve with the help of this projection operation. Undesirable, the what and all column you no need, they will be ignored in the resulting table. And this projection operations, it is going to deal with columns. It is called as a vertical slices of a table. That is, it is going to return or it is going to process only on the vertical slices of a table. There is vertical slices in the sense only it is going to deal with this row wise. Sorry, column wise. And next is we will see the example. What is the rule for writing this projection is you have to include the table name and the list of desired columns. What columns you need, that should be written over here. This is the column and this is part is the table name. So part is a table. In that table only you are going to write 2 columns. It may contain many columns in that particular table, but you have only retrieved this part description and cost of the both columns that you have retrieved. Next is selection. Here also you're going to, the selection operation is going to select rows from a table. How the projection operation select only the columns from the table, here the selection operation is going to select rows from the table based on a condition or condition. So it is going to apply a condition and it is going to select only rows. So what the condition means, you have to apply one operator. That operator may be of conditional operator, logical operator, etc., etc. So conditional operator means it is equal to, greater than or equal to, not equal to, less than or equal to, so and so. And logical operators means and or not. So these operators are used to create combined condition. As the name indicates, the selection operation is going to retrieve the rows. It is called as a horizontal slices of a table will be retrieved. That is, if there is a table, this particular row wise data will be retrieved. So row wise, so it is called as a horizontal slices. So this example is applied with the help of the same part table. So resulting table will have the same number of columns as the original table. We will see the example. See, this is the part table. Here the resulting table contains a condition called cost column. You are giving greater than 10. So which particular data satisfies this condition will be selected and displayed in the form of rows. So totally this part table consists of 4 columns. All the columns will be displayed, but only the rows means the rows that is going to satisfy this condition will be displayed. This is the difference between the projection and the selection. Selection is going to deal only with the row, that is the horizontal slices will be displayed. And the next operation is product. So what is meant by product? A product is nothing but it is a combination of everything in both the tables. You're going to combine everything. collecting everything, that is called the form of a Cartesian product. So Cartesian product always give you big tables, huge number of tables. Why you are saying it is a huge number of table means, if your first table has x rows and the second table has y rows, your product will be x into y rows. That is, it has been multiplied. Rows will be multiplied. And if your table, the first table has m columns and the second table has n columns, your product will be m plus n columns. Rows will be multiplied and columns will be added. So, obviously, that Cartesian product will lead to big tables. See, now is an example, a department table, employee table. Resulting table is, it will be in the form of a Cartesian product, so huge table. So how this employee and department table is multiplied is, employee table has two rows, Carter and Albert, a department has three rows. So you are going to multiply, rows will be multiplied. As I said in the previous slide, here rows will be multiplied, columns will be added. So rows, if you multiply, you will get 6 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 rows will be there. And columns, you will have to add 2 columns. Only here 1 column and here 1 column. So 1 plus 1, 2 column. Here 1 column, here is the second column. This is the concept of Cartesian product. So employee has 1 column and department has 1 column. So 2 columns totally in the resulting table. Next comes the assignment operation. Assignment is, it will create a new table from the existing table. It is not a new one, since in the previous examples what we have learned, no, this is called as assignment operator. All the examples what we learned in previous examples, this is the assignment operator. This is a simple donation. So here like this, it will create a new table. And the next operation is join. Join operation means it is ability to get related data from a number of tables. You're going to join based on some relation. So based on the common set of values, which does not have to have the same name in both the tables, but does not have to have the same domain in both the tables. This is a condition that is used to create the tables in the form of join. So when a join is based on equality of value, it is known as natural join. Similarly, you will have some other types called as outer join, non-equi join and self join. These are the other types of joins. Or this join is a very important topic and it is a big topic that will come across in your free subsequent units. Simple example, to get the employee information along with the department information, a join can be carried out using employee and the department table. So here the department number column will be the common column in the both the tables, and will be this column will be used for your joining condition. We will see an example. See, the both tables have been joined with this help of this join operation, that is employee table and department table. The condition which is used to establish this relationship is one common column called as department number. So that particular department number is used to join. So this means, this expression, what it denotes, that is, join a row in a employee table with a row in the department table, where the department number value in the employee table is equal to the department number value in the department table. So this equality condition, the common column condition, is used to join, where this department number in the employee table should match the department number in the department table. If it match, it will be joined. So here we have to follow some set of subsequent operations, that is a series of operations should be carried out. This is a very great disadvantage. That is, you have to perform a product, that is 5 rows and 3 rows. So 15 rows you will get, and you have to perform a selection operation to select the rows where the department number values are equal. So this is a condition. So you have to select. And the third one, you have to apply as a projection operation to perform the eliminating duplicate department number column. So like subsequent step-by-step operations you have to carry out so that this will be the outcome result. And the ninth last operation of relational algebra is division operation, which is used to identify the rows in one table that have a certain relationship to all rows in another table. You have to see the relationship condition in this division and you have to apply. So example is project and project paths. Resulting table, what you have is you are going to divide this project paths table with this project by applying this divisions. So what the result what you get is part number 11. This is the result what you got. So to find out which paths are used in every project, you have to divide this project paths by project. Which part, this particular part is used in which projects. So the first, the columns, how you get is from the dividend project paths that are not in the divisor project. Only this particular dividend will be retrieved in the columns. And rows, it is a subset of the projection project paths. So to get this 11th data, we have to apply the projection operator. This is the operator that I applied to get this value 11. From this project part, you have to select the particular column. Projection means, hope you remember, you're going to select the vertical slices of a table, that is, you're going to select the columns. Next, the row part number, this particular part number row, if and only if project number part number is in the dividend for every value in the divisor. So if it satisfies, this particular 11 will be retrieved. This is called the join operation. So till now we have learnt about the relational algebra operations from union to join. Union to division. Now we will see some other application. There are some examples of this relational algebra. We have one table that what I have shown you in the previous class. From that, you're going to find which employee is working on a project in Miami during the year 2003. So the sequence or subsets set of operation you carried out is you have to join both tables, that is project 2003 and employee table, based on a condition project number is a common column, and you have to apply the selection operator to select the particular row and E name is a particular column. So if you apply this, you can get able to get the result as carta. Similarly, this is the second example. This is the SQL query that you have to apply, can apply in this relational algebra. That is, you can easily translate those relational concepts what you have learned into SQL queries. Projection, selection, join, and Cartesian product, or those, this is the examples. This topic will also be covered in the subsequent unit. And this comes as second language, relational calculus. So far, we have learned the theoretical languages, relational algebra. Now we are shifting into the second relational theoretical language, relational calculus. As stated previously, it is a non-procedural language. The programmer specifies the data requirement and the system will generate the operation needed to produce a table with that particular required data. So this is general syntax that you are going to follow in this relational calculus. There is a totally different format. Here will be the result equal to column list, the list of columns and a colon and the expression and the condition will be followed. So this is somewhat R dot your name, table name, sorry, column name or dot salary. Since this is a column list, this is the expression. After the colon, you have to write expression, condition, etc. After you applying, you will get the result as from for the table, employee and department. This will be the answer. This is the second example. So what we have learned in this class is theoretical relational language and types of languages, relational algebra and relational calculus and operations that has been applied in relational algebra and some examples applied in both algebra and calculus. Thank you.